Thou shalt not take credit for your father's good deeds. What you have before you is a German map in German of the greatest achievement of the Germanic people in the history of the world, supposedly. Let me repeat that to you so that it sinks in. A German map, and there are many like this one, a German map in German of the greatest historical achievement of the Germanic people. Yeah? Did you get that? Where are the Germans? Where are the Germans on this map? Where? Can anybody point out the Germans? I mean, we got, you know, Burgundy. What is this? Is that German or is that French? What is that exactly? We got Aleman, you know, a conglomerate of a bunch of different tribes. Okay. We got, what else do we got? Franken. We have the Franks. Kind of sounds like France, right? We have the Saxons. Cool. Frisians. I'm not saying this correctly, but Thuringer, however you say that, right? Okay. These, we got that. But none of those people call themselves German. Okay? But what you, the thing that you would most associate with German today, right? Because you were told to do that. That, okay? That's all kind of right here. Yeah? Where are the Germans? We see Goths, right? We see Sweben. These are all German names, okay? This is not what those people call themselves. We have Ostro. Where are my Slavs at? What does that mean? It doesn't mean Austria. Is there Austria anywhere on this map? That other quote-unquote German country? I mean, most people today, if you ask them, they'll tell you that Prussia was Germanic, right? Like, insanity. This is what happened to history. This is what most people think. Where are the Germans on this map? This is, guys. Let me try to repeat this yet again so that it sinks in, because this is how profound this is. This is how a simple, plain map such as this one, a little old document, can tell such a profound story if you know how to read it correctly. German map in German of the greatest Germanic achievement in the history of the world. What did they do? They toppled Rome. They destroyed the great Roman Empire. Threw humanity into the Dark Ages. For hundreds of years, we weren't able to recover from what these Vandals did. History tells us these Germanic people on a German map in German representing the greatest achievement of the Germanic people. Where are the Germans? Where are the Germans? Nowhere to be found. Now, suppose we take this map and we remove all the color. And by that, I mean bias, right? We change the shape of these somewhat recognizable landmasses. We change all these names into some, I don't know, unpolluted language so that you don't know what they refer to. And we just represent these countries as they are on this map, changing all their names and shapes, but keeping their relationships insofar as their size to one another, okay? Imagine we were able to do that. What's the biggest country on the map? What would be the biggest country on the map? If there was a war that were to break out and you knew nothing about what I just described to you, about these people on this map, which side would you want to be on? Well, clearly the big white one, right? Obviously, logically, this is the side you'd want to be on if there was a war happening at that point in time in Europe. Of course. What side is that? Those are the slaves. Did they call themselves slaves? I don't think so. They probably call themselves Suavi, Suabian, Goths, whatever. They had a whole bunch of names for themselves, right? Why do you think the historical winners, the Holy Roman Empire, why do you think they call you slaves and servants? You do understand where Serbian comes from, right? Serbian, servant, slave, Slav. Why do they call you that? And why do they call themselves Germain? Oh, man. And why does the Portuguese language sound kind of Russian, kind of Polish? Why is that? Let me repeat this one more time so that it sinks in. This is a German map in German, representing the greatest historical achievement of the Germanic people. And nowhere on this map can you find anything that closely approximates the word German. There are no Germans on this map. None whatsoever. Weird how that happens. But you could go to Wikipedia right now and find out who the Vandals are. If you know how to read, it'll tell you right there who the Goths were. Ostro. Davai, Ostro. Where are my Slavic people at? What does Ostro mean? What does it mean? Sharp? Like a sword? Like an axe? Somebody who fucks shit up, right? who gives it all they got. They go for it, right? Ostro. Austria. Oh, man, the history is such a joke. It's such a lie. They say, I don't know if it's true or not, I never heard him say it, but they say Napoleon stated, you know, the guy that liberated, for whatever reason, liberated all these Slavic people. What did he say? Napoleon. I wonder if his name had anything to do with Poland. I wonder what our true history is. I wonder. Anyway, what did he say, supposedly? That if the Slavic people were to wake up, if they were to know their own history, they would be a completely different people. If... If the Slavic people, if they knew their true history, they just might. They just might sack Rome yet again. But they're not, that's not supposed to happen. No, you're supposed to be a slave. You're supposed to be a servant. Okay? You, who are, to this day, the most numerous people in Europe, holding the most land in Europe. You are being told that you're the slave, you're the servant, and these Germans, right, these foreign invaders, they all of a sudden somehow became Germain. And you became their slave. And they need to keep you in bondage, if only mental. But I mean, obviously, it's a lot more than that, right? They need to keep you in bondage because if you were to wake up, you just might sack Rome again. And of course, they don't want that. But, you know, this so-called totally germane, totally genuine Germanic awakening by all these true revisionist historians, right? That whole movement is going to get hundreds of thousands of views on YouTube. And anybody speaking the truth, reading the maps logically, how they're supposed to be read, anybody attempting to do that, well, they're not going to get the light of day. And I get it. Like, my videos aren't produced very well, whatever. But anyone could pick this up and run with it. Right? You don't got to even give me credit. Just speak the truth. Try to be logical. Tell it like it is, like it was. Try to reconstruct real history. How does what I just presented to you not make perfect sense? How? It is what it is, man. I know my history. And now you know yours. At least a little bit. So let's do our best to speak the truth and let's not blame the son for his father's wrongdoings.